Hey, welcome to TFG 1, Episode 5. I'm Fly Guy from Fly Guy Toys. This is...
Chefatron right here.
I should have introduced you there. YouTube.com/Chefatron. Are we going to get the thumb? There we go. He gets a thumbs up. Okay. Courtesy of your iOS app. What was the other one we learned last week? Was it like that was the lasers or something?
Maybe.
There we go. Giving love to the show. Love it, love it, love it. Is that lasers? Lasers. Yeah. Oh, right. I love that. We had so much fun after we recorded the last one. We just dicked about for half an hour. Anyway, Mr. Friends and I are back to just do our fifth episode of Transformers News, deals, and just some stuff that's coming up. Not a whole bunch of news, but still some interesting stuff. You and I were up just after the last show ended, and we were both up at crazy hours in the morning trying to get some of the new Transformers. You were trying to get a swoop at 3 a.m. for you.
Oh, I did.
You did. You got it. So yeah, a lot of fans this week. That's probably a good thing just to dive straight in. Everything we're talking about in this show is in the description in the video. So all the links, if you want to buy stuff or you want to go and see Franz's reviews, definitely do, by the way. Go and check that out. And links to other stuff. Everything's in the description we talk about. So the first thing was... Pre-orders went up just last week for Swoop, Sunstreaker, Sideswipe. Who was the other one? There was one other one. Let's think.
Was it Starscream?
Shockwave was the other one. Right. It was. I knew there was another one. So there was a bunch of figures that went out, and just going to share them on screen, just some other stuff. There's a bunch of other things here. There's a bunch of 3-0 figures, actually, that got added to Amazon recently as well, which I didn't realize they were up there too, for not the most expensive price in US dollars. Sideswipe for a 3-0, what's that, 10 inch metallic diecast, pretty good. I was very tempted with some of these, so I thought they were much more, because the Optimus I'd bought before, the MDLX, was way more expensive. So yeah, anyway, side story. Swoop was the big one and sold out within the day on Amazon, if not half the day. But still is available. BBTS, Entertainment Earth, we'll put links underneath, but it's still available. So you can still, as of recording this, you can still go and get a Swoop on Entertainment Earth. So Amazon clearly is the place that people want to buy stuff, understandably. But yeah, it sold out pretty quick. And then the other one was Shockwave. I love this guy. I'm really kind of getting a lot of heat because I've said I prefer this one to the comic version, the other one, and the boxed kind of cell shaped version.
Right.
I love this guy. I don't know. I just think he's awesome. So looks really good. Bumblebee movie stuff to me, that opening first couple of minutes was just like, that's what I want in a Transformers movie. But pretty cool looking figure. Lots of them still available. He's not going to sell out. Sideswipe, which we talked about before. Blaster, we talked about before. Sunstreaker? My name's mixed up. Sunstreaker. We talked about as well. And of course, the Party Wagon, which we talked about, the TMNT. So pretty much at least 5 brand new-ish Transformers just since the last episode alone. But you've already got in hand this, what looks like a really cool figure.
Yeah.
Tell us a little more about this guy. Now, you and I bitched about the slippers, the little slip-on weird little shoes he's got, which is...
I don't want to spoil too much because my review is going to be up tonight. In the morning for the US. But the slippers aren't bugging me as much. And I'm going to say this: it looks cool, but it is more than meets the eye. When you take this thing out of packaging, this is the first thing that's going to greet you. I mean, looseness of this arm, and I was like, what is going on here?
That's wild.
And I'm not sure if I got another lemon, you know me, with my luck on with Hasbro products, but that's the first thing that greeted me with this figure. And the review just went downhill from then. And it's not without its merit. It has its good stuff. I think you're going to love the robot mode. Great, great homage to the old Cybertron 2004, 2003, a show, but
yeah.
But the quality, you could put this thing on a scale with Silverbolt, and I guarantee Silverbolt's going to be much heavier than this guy.
Is that Kevil on his back? Is that kind of
Oh, yeah, wait, this okay. It's part of the alt mode. It's part of the alt mode, so it's necessary, and it doesn't really bother me as much. They even put this cyber key. If you guys are from, I do a comparison with the old cyber key. The old cyber keys look like this. So they activated the gimmick. So if you put it, figures back in the day, 20 years ago, were like super awesome. They were really, really cool, solid figures. They had really cool gimmicks with the cyber keys. But they did that. I thought there was gonna be a gimmick, but it was merely aesthetic. It was an homage. It was okay. That quality, man.
The quality was there.
Yeah.
I mean, he looks great in the box. He really does. Mm-hmm. And I was very, very tempted. And it was when we spoke the lot. I mean, posing looked great. He looks really bucked out, like a really cool kind of Gundam-like character. And I will definitely pick him up. Hopefully, if I get a bit of a reduction in price, if we see one. Even the non-robot mode looks pretty good, I think.
The jet mode. Jet mode is pretty close to how he. I mean, it's not perfect, but it'll give you that nostalgic vibe to the old show. However, getting him into that ship mode. That's another story. I don't want to spoil. I don't want to spoil too much in my review, but this figure, he kept me up. I'm sorry. I don't mean to be too shallow about it, but it kept me up after doing the review.
It's one of the things I always loved about your reviews way back, because you've been doing these for like 10 years on your other channels. But when you love a figure, you love a figure. Yeah. When you don't like a figure, boy, you don't like a figure. You're very passionate about it. And you know what? I get it. You're right. It is toys, but it's really important to us. We love these things, and when they're just not good, they suck. But how's the feet on that Starscream? Because it looks so thin. Does he stand okay? Is he?
Yeah, it actually stands okay. It's got some heel spurs. Actually pretty good. I actually like the feet. I'm not complaining about the feet. It's actually one of the... They're very stable, actually.
Okay, good.
But the...
It's an issue.
The issue of the plastic is anywhere you see blue bits, like the shoulder, I just showed off the shoulder that just detached, the thigh pieces. Anywhere there's blue, that's where El Cheapo Hasbro came into place.
It is a $35 US price point. I mean,
I checked on Amazon. If you want to get it, like if you're here in Manila and you want to get it for free shipping or with shipping, you'll need to shell out something like $65 to $75 now, which is crazy. When stocks arrive, I'm sure it's going to go down, but
yeah. For sure. It's one of the things you and I have not talked about, but I've talked about it in other podcasts and shows, is it's that oh my God, I must get a figure. It's rising. It's so hot right now. Yeah, I've got it. I don't need it. It just dips and dips and dips. And there's this window, this brief window where no one really wants it. And then it starts building up again, and then secondhand market, and it's just off to the races. So you've got to watch when you're buying it. But it does look good. I think actually seeing that there, and I'll watch your review, it's not as bad looking. And I have to say, just again, just to share that one extra time, that the feet, the slippers, the point we were talking about there, that looks like a huge gap down there.
Yeah.
It doesn't look as bad on yours. So
it's part of the transformation, because when you transform it, you have to move the foot this way. So the gap is necessary. But if you if you press the foot closer to his leg,
that's why it's different.
It should be fine. It should be fine. Okay. I really think you like the robot mode since you're not going to transform him too much. Yep. I think you're going to like this figure. I just hope yours doesn't get that quality issue that mine did.
With the arms popping off, but it's just a joint that pops right back on easy, isn't it? It's not like super.
Yeah. Well. I think it's case to case because mine, it's just loose. It doesn't become tight. It doesn't.
I see me.
I think it's a quality issue. Like, you know, the universe hates me.
It does not. It does not. The universe likes you very much. I had the same issue, and I think several countries had the same issue. I don't know why. It was like a second run or something. But a bunch of G.I. Joes, when they first came out, had incredibly loose joints. The first Snake Eyes, some of the Jukes, like wobbly legs all the time. They were really, really bad. It's like they didn't perfect the kind of drop down thigh.
We had those too, and then the second versions came out.
Yeah,
much better.
But I think one of the tips that a lot of people were saying, and I did, was a little bit of preferably crappy super glue in that joint and just hold it up, and it makes it a little tackier and tougher to move. Some people see furniture polish up it sprayed in the joint, but I thought the super glue really worked well for me for a couple of Joes and some Turtles in the past, some Loyal Subjects ones that were really kind of just really loose. So it might help some of you guys out there. Leave a note in the comments and tell us, how do you fix your flappy bits, your loose joints? Tell us in the comments how you fix them. We'd love to know if there's any tips that we have not heard of. That was the new stuff, or the stuff that was out in pre-orders. Some of the other things we've got to talk about here today. We'll get into some new releases coming up. But one of the articles that Cybertron.com shared, one of the larger Transformers news sites, was potential end of the line for Masterpiece figures. Did you hear about this? No.
Yeah, I'm not sure if it's ending the line. I mean, toys itself, because I tried reading the copy. They're going to change it from MP Transformers MP to Transformers MPG, and MPG, that's the line with the trains. You've seen the train bots, right?
Yes.
The combining train. I didn't even know who those guys were. I mean, I heard of them, but I didn't bother with that line. So I think they're going to turn.
Yeah.
They're going to turn them into MPG. Not entirely sure what the G stands for. Is it Ginrai or Jinrai or
Ginrai? Whatever that. I don't know what that means.
I don't know what it means. So, are they transitioning from the odd sizes, small, medium, large masterpieces to just all big masterpieces? That's what I'm getting with this. So, because the new Optimus Prime with in the MPG line is the whole one with the trailer, which I guess would fit the scale of a train. So does that mean that the MPG line is like all train sized masterpieces?
Just a quick Google there, and I didn't know, so apologies, Transformer fans, if you knew and you're scoffing at the screen saying, oh, how could they not know? Jinrai is Godmasters.
Right.
Known as Power Masters in the West.
Right.
There you go. Right. Still doesn't really the difference to me, but
so I guess it's probably changing the scale. I don't think we'll be seeing any more like small figures like Bumblebee or Cliffjumper or, you know.
Gotcha.
I think they've done most of G1. They're trying to move now into the anime.
Yep.
The anime characters.
That's not so bad. So, I mean, it kind of makes sense. They've done 100. Let's change things up a little bit. Change some skill and do some other stuff. Yeah, that might be. Let's see what happens. So, yeah, not the end of the Masterpiece line, as I thought, now that I actually read it and didn't just go by the headline. Yes, so they will continue on under Transformers MPG, miles per gallon. That's not bad. But that's one thing for them. Talking of MPG, let's get a look at the actual MPGs that were revealed since in between our last episode and this last week and whatever it was. These are pretty damn awesome. I know you've seen them. We've briefly talked about them, but a couple of them here. So we've got two connecting Super God Master Force MPGs. Or sorry, these are MPs. Wow, this is pretty incredible looking. And lots of kits, swap out heads, swap out hands, blast effects, and just the most gorgeous looking Optimus. Really, really nice. Very G1, obviously, but just different enough and kind of still super articulated. So it's up on Amazon Japan. And if we have a look at them, there's some details on the pages. I think I could translate that a little bit. If I translate to English, we'll get a little bit more. It's going to change it for me. There you go. Dismiss. So, yeah, there you go. The Transformers Masterpiece MP60 Jinrai. So that's basically the truck we're talking about there. But, man, he's got flaps. He's got extendable flaps and bendable bits. And I thought this would be so G1-ish. It would, you know, have the empty back at the, you know, the kind of way it would transform. But it's not. It's really quite awesome looking, actually. It is digital rendered, so it might change, obviously, between then and now. But I'm all for a good pose and articulation. And doesn't appear to be a lot of kibble or mess.
Can I give a little background on this thing?
Go for it. Go.
The way I understand it, it's like two different products. The first one is just the masterpiece one. It's without the trailer. It's the cab. The second one is the robot with the trailer that combines. And I believe these products are based off of when I was a kid. I was like, it was back in the 1990 or 1989. I think it was for my 13th birthday or 12th birthday, I got this actual G1 toy. It's called Power Master Optimus Prime. Now, the Power Master line was, they had, instead of turning into a head, the headmasters, or turning into a gun, the target masters, they turned into engines. And the engines, when you turn the little figure into an engine, it would unlock, you push it into the chest of the figure, and then it would unlock the transformation, like the hinge for the way to transform this guy into robot mode. So it sort of unlocked it, and I learned the hard way because I transformed my Optimus Prime without the engine, and it broke. I know, because that was the whole gimmick about it. I didn't read instructions when I was a kid. So you put the engine, you put the engine, and it would allow you to transform the figure. That's why they were called Power Masters. And one of the best ones was this one, the Power Master Optimus Prime. He combined with his trailer and he turned into a bigger robot. And the Japanese version came, the old G1 Japanese version came with a small blue trailer that turned into his wings and his gun. It was called the God Ginrai or the God Jinrai trailer.
Gotcha. Okay.
So Hasbro in the Generations line, even the Generations, a modernized version of these G1s, they released a version of this several times. There was one with the pack, and it was called Delt Magnus Optimus. I forgot what his name, but that was the whole idea behind this. Now they're turning it into a masterpiece, and I'm not in the masterpiece game anymore, but I'm so like salivating over this figure. I'm so tempted, but it's like $300.
It's a lot of money.
$300 for this thing. And that's like the cheapest you can get, $300.
It's pretty expensive. I think even the, obviously you're getting an Optimus in a trailer, which is one release. And then the other one is just the Optimus, but the single Optimus is,
it's like $150.
Yeah. It's like, so even that alone is quite a different figure, but I mean, I'd be sold on that one, but yeah, that's a lot of money for
That one is the small robot. That really is masterpiece-fied version of the small robot, which, well, you know, collectors were okay with it, but nobody really displayed him as a small robot. Everybody combined him with the trailer. And
gotcha.
But it's still a good product. But I mean, $150 and $300. So if you buy both, that's like $450.
That is a lot. So I'm just looking at the scale there and the size, the package dimensions. That's the package dimensions. But, you know, even within that, you're talking the smaller one has got to be around the kind of 8 inches size.
Yeah, 8 9 inches.
Which is pretty good. I mean, the poses on this guy alone, I'm sold on the pose and the way that the flaps are bending and moving and the articulation. I'm like, I can dig this guy. I like him. He's really nice. But on the other one, we're talking, let me just bring that up on screen.
They're like leader class size, I think.
Yeah. Does not use batteries, it says there. 14 by 15 by 28 centimeters. So it's got to be about 10 inches tall. So maybe a couple inches more, maybe an inch or two more.
Yeah.
It's not like super big. It's not like...
10. I think so. I think you're right.
So, I mean, the box kind of limits what you're going to get. So the biggest dimension is going to be the length of it. So 28 centimeters, again, is about, what are we talking, 11 inches. So it's about 10-inch figure versus a, maybe a 9 or an 8-inch figure. So it's not, still a lot of money, though. Still a lot of money. I just don't know quite why it's so expensive. Maybe it'll be cheaper if Hasbro were to bring it here, but I don't think they will, because
they're probably going to sell it as an exclusive, like on Pulse. Mm. They're probably going to put this one as a Pulse exclusive. But nice. I was going to say something, but it could get me into trouble. But
like what?
I was going to say
swear.
I'll probably just do the same thing I did with this guy and just wait for the third party products of these things.
After we talked about this last week, I had a couple of people ask me, where'd you get that figure? So, yeah, that's so...
Third party is probably... They'll probably do a better job. They'll probably put more die cast. They'll probably fix the issues. I'm sure this thing's going to have issues. Because have you bought the MP44?
No, I don't. The only one I've got is a Power of the Prime Soundwave and Optimus, are MPs, I think. No. The only MP I've got is the Bumblebee movie Optimus.
Right. Right now, the most definitive G1 Optimus in masterpiece format is the MP44. They released, remember we talked about in the other previous show, they released one without the trailer, the MP44S, has the silver and all that. That's the most definitive one. And even that mold, a lot of collectors are complaining that it is too backpack heavy, transformation is crazy, and the third-party companies like Magic Square, you know, they've come up with something better.
I mean, not even third-party, but... Yolo Park, I was kind of showing you this week. I haven't even noticed it yet, but it's one of those kind of snap together, slightly modelish kits. But you can't get any more G1 than that. It's pretty. And scale of it, packaging is beautiful. It's official. It's licensed. So I'll get a review of that and we'll have a look at that one. But it's, I think there's a bit of a kind of. There's a bit of a snobbery, I think, with some figures. Oh, it must be Hasbro, it must be Takaratomi. I get a lot from a lot of people, and it's like, fair enough, if that's what you like. But but third party, and it's I've got more money to buy more toys.
Right.
Yeah, I'm all up for that. Right. But
I was going to ask you about that model kit.
I still haven't opened it. I know I sent you a picture this week. It's like, I haven't opened it yet. So, but I'm sure you'll probably see that everywhere where you are.
It's not yet out. People who pre-ordered it on hobby shops are still waiting on it. It's supposed to come out this month. Pre-orders, like Philippines, we're getting stuff late now. We get them dead last to the rest of the world.
It's the US seems to be getting it first again, pretty much, which is what it always used to be. But for the last couple of years, it was the kind of Asian side of the world that got it first. But what it's like, but it's a much cheaper figure. The fact that you have to put it together, but super articulated. If you've ever had any of the Yolo Park figures,
how much did you get it for? I mean, was it the same as?
Remember offhand, which is really bad.
Was it like $30? Is it if it's the same as the Rise of the Beasts one? $30, right?
Wasn't super expensive. Do you know it was only $43 US?
43, okay.
43, about 60 all in shipping. That's nothing for a 10 inch, super articulated, officially licensed transformer that's got die cast in it with a stand. Yeah, I'll take that. Thanks. So,
it's probably,
I haven't reviewed it yet, so maybe a piece of garbage. But I don't think so. Going by all the other Yolo Parks, if you've had any Yolo Park figures, they're just great. They're really, really good. They are Mario kits. But
have you had quality issues with Yolo Park? Because out here in Manila, everybody's complaining about missing pieces, broken pieces from Yolo Park.
Definitely no missing pieces, because the tray's pretty much, there's only so many parts they can put in it. I think the boxes are not the most secure or stiff cardboard. They're really bendy. So it's one of those things that you've got a box at the end with just one little sticker. So, and they're sitting in a top tray, I don't think, without a piece on top of them. So they could, you could easily shake a bit out the box.
Okay.
Maybe.
Okay.
Quality-wise.
Yeah, we got a lot of returns. I mean, the stores I've been to, people have been returning them. Missing pieces, broken pieces, especially the Rise of the Beast Optimus Prime.
I think there's some issues with the Optimus Primal being a little bit... some joints would move away quite quickly, but again, if I needed to, I'd put a bit of super glue or something on it just to kind of fix the joint. But they are model kits, and they were incredibly cheap. I think I think both of those kits I got delivered for about 30 US delivered. Okay. That's kind of nuts. I think the price has gone up. I think they've been really popular now, especially with the Cheetor and the
Rhinox. Was it Rhinox?
Yeah. What did piss me off though was the fact that you didn't get a gun with Optimus, and you didn't get the Wasp attack mask with Bumblebee. You had to buy the others. Really, Yolo Park? There's a lot of third parties that have popped up on eBay, AliExpress, that have basically taken the weapons and 3D printed them and $10. So there is a way around that, I think. But talking to G1 Optimus, there's another, we talked about this before, but it's now, it was leaked and then it's pulled and then it was coming, and now it's definitely the thing. It is the Transformers All for One. Relive the magic of the 84 animated series on the big screen. So it is the first four episodes, which coincidentally Hasbro Pulse have pulled from YouTube, I'm reliably told, which is kind of stupid, but there you go. They had all the episodes up there, but they pulled the first four, or first three. And I believe what it is a screen reading for one episode, so about 22 minutes, 18 minutes. And then the other three episodes stuck on the end. It doesn't talk about quality. It doesn't talk about HD, 4K, anything. It just, you know, go and see these again, relive them in cinemas, which alone is enough to, you know, get your 80s hair and your bum bag and, you know, your 80s soundtrack and live it all up. But a table read with Peter Cullen and Frank Welker and more as they basically read the first episodes. It's a split screen between the episode and them, and then the final three episodes. It's like, you know, I know a couple of people that I knew locally were like, meh, and they're big Transformers fans. So there you go. It's up to you whether you want to know. We'll put a link. This isn't the proper link, but I'll put a link to the proper site. But basically, it links to your local cinema. So the best thing to do is go to your local cinema. I think it's pretty much larger Western-speaking countries. So I don't know about the distribution. So certainly US, UK, Australia, maybe a couple of European countries. I don't know. Check your local cinemas. Transformers All for One, I think it was called. Or 40th Anniversary Transformers is what it's all about. A couple of other things then, I think, then we are done. The last thing we've got here was not really for you and I, but more for a US audience, is Holothon, which is the Target US kind of excuse to have some exclusives together, is happening this Friday. So Friday the 12th of April to, God, the way they do their dates, man, that's my head in, 10th of May. 8 a.m. Central Time, so that's like 6 a.m. East Coast, something, 11 a.m. Eastern, something like that. So basically, one of the key things in there was Transformers. The Transformers Legacy United 4-pack is available. So you can or can't pre-order right now? No. Oh, pre-orders are sold out. Oh, right, damn. Maybe there's more going up for Holothon. Maybe that's what it was. But why would you have that on the Holothon page and it's not available? Anyway, there's more figures going to be available there. There's a bunch of other stuff. So we'll see what is coming down the way. I guess they're going to have more stock, I would hope. There's a bunch of other stuff in there. So, but I think that was the only Transformers that were coming. Yeah, they all went off a pre-order, the McFarlane. So
the four-pack. Was it a store exclusive for the four pack? I think it's
it was a Target exclusive in the US.
Hooray! Target
exclusive. I know. Target exclusive in the US. It was a Zing exclusive in Australia, which is a kind of like it's owned by GameStop. Transformers. I'm still getting over the fact that there's a Transformers character called Squeeze Play, which just sounds so wrong at so many levels. So for $165 Australian, you can get the... is this Squeeze Play? I can't remember who's who.
Yeah.
This is the crap one that no one wants, right? This is the terrible one.
Yeah. It's a G1 name. You know, back in the 80s, they named their figures like weird names.
Yeah. It's Cuff Jumper, Squeeze Play, Tarn, and Tarantulas. How original. The slightly updated Tarn and the other one, Cliff Jumper. So there's a bunch of people trying to buy that one. This is the other one I was talking about. This turned up. So this was a Walmart US exclusive. Turned up in Australian stores. Again, their GameStop Zing, whatever you want to call it, for 60 Australian. About 40 US are kind of the same price. They didn't show the box of it, but it's a nice chance for fans outside the US to get hold of that. I believe Hasbro Pulse in the UK, and I guess your hobby shops for you. Did you see that at all? Did it come up anywhere for you?
It's all on pre-order, but people aren't really ordering it because you're going to get another one with the three-pack, the Takara Tomy three-pack.
Right. Yeah.
Which I thought was a better color for Shockwave.
No. But for as we said the last time, I think you, for years, no Shockwaves, and then all of a sudden, have three Shockwaves.
Wheeljack. They've done like two Wheeljacks. Like,
sideswipes. They're a strange firm. They really are a strange firm. It's like, yeah. Why didn't you paste that? But never mind. It's the way it goes. So that was pretty much it for that. Thank you. There was a couple of comments on the last episode. Again, we're pretty young. We're only five episodes in here, but that's pretty much it. Anything other Transformers, things that you know of that happened, you want to, I don't know, raise or talk about or mention? No? No? Okay.
I was just going to say, you know, it's only start of the year. How many Optimus Primes have we? We have six Optimus Primes. First quarter of 2024. Are we going to get like 10 more Optimus Primes?
Totally. So there's a Hasbro. I think it's Star Wars, maybe Hasbro Pulse. They've got an upcoming. I've lost the thing I was going to say, which was there's a live stream happening, I think, this weekend. I think it may be Marvel, actually. I don't think it's Transformers.
I think it's Marvel Legends.
I did
see one on Instagram, I think. It was they're doing Marvel Legends again.
Yeah. It's Marvel Legends. My apologies. April 15th. So there's nothing for Transformers. We know nothing anymore what's coming. So you're up to date, peeps. Let us know what you think. Leave a note in the comment. Tell us how you fix your loose joints and your figures. You can follow this guy on youtube.com/Chefatron. There's a link underneath there, Chefatron. You can find a link to me, Fly Guy Toys. You're watching the channel, so there you go. And we'll see you for TFG1 Episode 6 coming up soon. Cheers. To the lasers.